بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
وذكر فإن الذكرى تنفع المؤمنين.
بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow me to connect to your hearts and for you all to be motivated enough to change any element in your life that is dragging you behind in this dunya. Many people do not feel the reality in this life because of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given people so much that they think that they provide for themselves. If you are hungry, you go and eat. If you become thirsty, you go and drink. When you become hot, you turn on the air condition. When you become cold, you turn on the heater. And Muslims, you have the ability to make judgments in this life, to make decisions, but after your death, then what? O people of the world, O Ummah of Muhammad, O rulers of the world, O you oppressing person, O you oppressed person, I call upon every person who can hear my voice, the rich, the poor, the famous and the unknown, the old and the young. After your death, what decisions can you make? Which God will you be able to submit to? Who can you follow? Who can you oppress? Who can you cheat? What fun can you have? You will no longer have control over your soul. At that time, who can you turn to for help? You will have no one to help you because it will be too late. And you will think to yourself, who can I blame but myself? O mankind, why do you see yourself so independent? Remember when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes the souls of every living thing, who will remain but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, al-wahid al-ahad? So you deceived person, you think that you are great and lofty, that you are too high and no one can reach your level. At the time of death, you will realize how low you really are and how high Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is. You will realize how you neglected Allah. You will realize how you neglected yourself. You will realize how you neglected your friends and family. And you will think to yourself, who can I blame but myself? My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, at the time of your death, you will not be able to do anything. No matter how much power you had, no matter how strong you were, no matter how much wealth you had, no one will be able to help you, and you will think, who can I blame but myself? So at this present time in your life, the remembrance of death is your cure. If you remember death, you will understand this life. You will understand what are your priorities in life. We were not sent to this world to make it our homes, nor to be oppressors, nor to make it a fun park where we commit every sin under the sun. This is not the reality of life. When you see a dying person on their deathbed in hospital, you will see all the doctors around them trying to work out what to do, what medicine to give, what operation to perform. They are planning, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is also planning. You need to understand, nothing happens against the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala orders or sets the time of death for a person, there is no one that can interfere. The angel of death will be the surgeon to extract the soul from the body. I recommend you all to see a person at the time of death. This should wake you up to reality. You will see the dying person's face turn pale. You will see them struggling to breathe their final breath. You will see them struggling to move their limbs. You will see them struggling to move their lips to speak. Often they fall in and out of consciousness. Their body starts to become cold. The dying person will be looking around, scared. Seeing their family around them, we can just imagine what they are thinking. My family, I gave you my life, so what can you do for me now? My family, I gave you my life. I gave you my wealth. I gave you my love. I gave you my care. So how can you help me now? My family, I gave you my life, so how long will you remember me for after my death? How long will you pray for me? But I say to you all, at that time, you'll think to yourself, who can I blame but myself? They would want to cry out to their family and say, O my wife, O my husband, O my children, O my family, please do not leave me. Please help me. O my family, which one of you is going to give me some of their lifespan? Just 1 or 2 years, just 1 month or a week, even a day. The blessed person is the one whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes easy for them to say the shahadatain at the time of death. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it easy for us at the time of our death. After that, you will see the dying person roll their eyes back. They will breathe in their final breath and their soul will be taken by the angel of death. The people will cry and the deceased will think, who can I blame but myself? So my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, I warn you, do not be deceived by this world. I warn you that you'll be brought out of your grave and you will be judged by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then it will be either everlasting bliss or an eternity of punishment. And finally, I leave you with to think about, who can I blame but myself?